Well, SIFMA is a trade association on behalf of the capital markets industry, works with our member firms on promoting diversity and inclusion as part of their business strategy. It's important regardless of the size of the firm, the type of business that they're in, from multi-line to monoline firms, everyone is focused on this as a goal because it's a necessity as firms look to serve their client base, look at the employee base that they're going to draw from.
We're really excited about today is having courageous conversations, and that's addressing some of those sensitive and sort of taboo topics that we historically haven't talked about and what we believe are really hindering us from making progress.
Measuring progress in diversity and inclusion has been a little bit of like this, how does it happen? Well, it happens the same way we measure progress with any other business imperative.
To do the work well, we need to be focusing on disparities, not just goals, but how do we lift all boats? And so that is what we are doing that's innovative in the space around diversity and inclusion. We are now diversity, equity, and inclusion.
Initially, the argument was simple. We want to attract the best talent available, and in order to do that, we need to be a welcoming and diverse workplace. In the world today, success depends on being able to understand the differences between people's needs, tastes, and preferences, and be able to customize financial solutions to them.
We have a holistic strategy that focuses on leadership development engagement, recruitment of diverse individuals, partnerships within the community. Another important part of our strategy is around building the cultural competence through D&I training of all of our employees. And then last but not least is really being committed to the community through our supplier diversity strategy. We continue to benchmark with our peers and really make sure that we're bringing great ideas from outside the company to our firm to continue to excel and advance our diversity inclusion strategy.
We are driving diversity and inclusion partly through HR, which is sort of traditional, but we're driving it from our client side. It's not something that's separate, it's part of something that we do, it's something that we build into everything that we're doing.
The diversity of thought allows us to fuel innovative solutions. We have been recruiting individuals that fall on the autism spectrum and bringing them into the firm and cultivating that talent pool. And we're making sure that we're investing in the professionals that we're bringing in to make sure they have the right managers who have the right training to be able to coach and develop them for their career progression.
Our founder, Ted Jones, actually took Wall Street to the farmers. That was an untapped market back in the day, and I think diversity is parallel to that. And so there's an untapped market that we all need to really pay attention to, because our future clients will be much different than the clients that we serve today.
And so incrementally, step by step, with patience and purpose, we are making progress on diversity and inclusion. Are we done? No. But are we methodical and persistent in our progress? Yes. And I think the industry and our member firms and all of the diversity and inclusion practitioners should be proud of their passion and their dedication to solving this problem.